Hey everyone, we're working on our 2006 Chevy Aveo today, and we will be replacing the rear trailing arm bushings, or as some other people call it, the rear axle bushing. What we've done here is we've raised the car, got it on jack stands, and safely supported. And before we lower the axle, we are going to disconnect the parking brake at its two mounting points. There's one right there. What we've done is we put some locking pliers on the actual metal tab because it was starting to move when we were turning that 10 mil bolt. We soaked it with penetrating fluid and managed to get it to move. The second one is on the bracket. There's the back side of it there. And that's another 10 mil where that ratchet is. And they're both moving. We're going to try to do this without having to open the brake line. The worst case, we'll do that and then have to bleed it later.
Any of a gas tank?
Axel.
I was like, I'll be a little bit more careful. Oh. Broke it.
Okay, so this bolt here that mounts up to the bracket snapped in half. What we'll do is when this bracket comes off later, we're going to chisel off that square nut right there and replace that with a nut and bolt. Not a big deal.
All the way to the end.
All right, we're gonna start trying to lower this axle now. Okay, so we're here under the car, on the passenger side. What we're gonna do first is we're gonna loosen the pivot bolt that goes through the bushing. 17 mil on both sides. Your bolt side is on the inner, your nut is on the outer. Right there. It'd be preferable to turn the nut, but since we don't have the clearance to get in there, we'll do it from the bolt side. Also, this is just to loosen it. We're not going to drop this yet because we won't be able to get this long bolt out as it's going to hit the gas tank. So we're just going to loosen this first, and then we're going to drop the four bolts that hold the bracket up to the body. I'll hold this one, and I've got someone else underneath to turn the other one. Nothing?
No.
Okay, so that method didn't work. Looks like the bolt might be frozen inside the collar that it sits in. So we're going to take the nut off first. Alright, we've got the nut loose. We're just going to work it out slowly. Tried to put a ratcheting wrench in there. Could not fit it in. Alright, so we're getting ready to drop the bracket. We have to take out that bolt there. This one, if you're using a ratchet, you're gonna hit the axle. We were able to get a low profile ratchet in there and get a couple turns on it to loosen the bolt. We'll have to use a wrench the rest of the way. And there are these two. Here, those were a little tougher to get out. Had to use an impact gun to get them started, but they'll come out properly now. And the last one is right here. That one faces more or less straight down. That one was pretty easy to get out. slowly but surely using a scooped 14 mil wrench here to take this one out. The other ones will be much easier. Okay, we've got the first one out. Had to do that one. It's just the regular offset wrench. This one's working pretty good here. We put an extension on the 14 just to clear the bracket, and that one's coming out really easy. You're gonna find Loctite on all these bolts. Makes it a little bit tougher to remove. And we're gonna use an impact gun on the last two.
Ready?
Ready. Okay.
Ready?
All right.
That was much easier.
Okay, so the bracket has come down. We still have the shock bolted in, and that's keeping everything elevated and keeping the pressure off this flex hose. The jack is not even being used right now. What we're gonna do is we're gonna pry this axle down a bit to get some more clearance and get the impact gun on that 17 mil bolt to see if we can shake it loose.
Ready? Okay.
Ready. It's turning, that's good.
It's loose, hold on.
Means it's not frozen. Okay, so now that we know it's loose, we can hit it out the rest of the way. Okay, so we got the bolt out. All we have to do is just use a thin screwdriver and tap it out toward the gas tank. Bracket comes right off after that, and we now have the old bushing. We're gonna try sawing through it. All right, so what we've done is we've taken a reciprocating saw and gone through the collar twice, there and there. And now what we're gonna do is we're just gonna take a drill and we're gonna continually go through the bushing with that to wear it all down. All right, so we've been working at this for about half an hour now. We've managed to saw about a quarter of the inner metal collar out and just taken a drill and gone, just drilled through this a bunch of times. You can see a bunch of light through it. We're gonna start trying to see if we can smash this, the inner metal collar out. Okay, so here's an inside view of what's going on. Let me see if we can help accelerate this here. Okay, try now.
Feels like it's coming.
Yep.
Here it comes. Oh.
Okay, next is to get the metal ring out here. We're gonna try to fold that in. Okay, so working from the inside, we're gonna try to lift up that lip and fold this metal, the outer metal collar in on itself.
All right, so we're working from the outside. We've got a chisel here, and we're just going through it. It's coming up nice and easy. Now there's nothing working against it. I'm just gonna get up to get a good swing. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Am I okay?
You're done.
I was gonna say, it's going in real easy.
All right, you can take that out and the whole thing will fall out. It out. All right, she's out. Okay, now that's done, we're going to take a wire wheel and clean that out. All right, now that we've got the inside of that board cleaned up enough, we're going to put in our new two-piece polyurethane bushings. We got these ones here from Whiteline, W63458. Nice two-piece design, no trouble putting these in. Okay, let's do it. Okay, we'll start with the outside. The car and put the next one in along with the inner bore. Just like that, it's replaced. Okay, to prep the bushing for reinstall, we're going to take some of the grease that came with it, and we're going to grease the outside face here where it will make contact against the bracket. I'd say that's good. Okay, and then we'll do the same thing on the inside one. The grease will take away any resistance when it needs to pivot. Okay. And we'll also put a bit of grease on the inside of the bracket too. Thank you. screwdriver to line it up. And then maybe on the other side too.
Hey, you know what? Keep that one in there just so it's...
Actually, here. Let me try straightening it out a bit first. There. Okay, now, did it go... Is it through?
Yep. Just pull it down, yeah.
Okay. The bolt will take care of the rest. All right. Let's take our bolt and our grease.
Yep. We're going to grease
the bolt, but not the threads. Can actually grease, put a bit of grease on the lower half of the threads since they won't be making contact with the nut. Okay. And we're going to send that back in the same way it came. Top it forward a bit. It should go by hand. There. All right. Before we put this back up, we'll tighten it, but not too tight. Okay, so holding the bolt side with a 17 mil wrench, we'll use another one to run this down. Maybe a little more. But not too tight, as you still need to be able to move the bracket.
Yep.
Just a little more. Okay. It's starting to feel kind of tight. Okay, as long as we can still move it. All right, let's put this back up in the car now. This is where you may need the jack stand. Okay, using the jack.
Hold on.
We're gonna try to lift this closer. Is it too high already?
Try one more time.
Up?
Yep. No, bring it back down.
Looks good.
Yeah, that's it right there.
Okay. Using the stud in the center of the bracket as your guide, we're going to get that in there, and I think we're close enough to start threading the bolts in by hand.
Yep.
All right, so we've got all four bolts on that bracket hand tight. We can take the jack out of the way now to give ourselves some more room. And now we gotta tighten these down. I wasn't able to find a factory torque spec, but through some trial, I'm gonna estimate that it's about 60 foot-pounds on the bracket bolts. The three of them you'll be able to get with the regular extension. This one, I'm using my Snap-on low profile with a 17 mil, and then we're gonna put a cheater bar on that one to tighten that up. Okay, so we learned a really important lesson here. All that talk about the rear inside bolt having to do that with a manual wrench, you could forget about all that. All we did was simply put a long extension, and it allowed us to get right on there square while we torque this, and we can use the same method when removing the bolt and reinstalling it. All right, so this is the passenger side rear axle bushing done. After we've torqued the four bracket bolts to 60 foot-pounds, we did tighten the 17 mil bolt and nut that go right through the pivot bolt, but not to its actual torque spec, which again, I don't have, but I borrowed it from another car with a similar part and it came up as 90 foot-pounds. We're gonna do this on ramps when the car is under load and the axle is in its at its normal ride height. And now we'll move on to the driver's side because that one's even worse.
Sorry, I forgot one small part here, was to put the two nuts back for your parking brake cables. So what we did is just took any old nut and bolt I had laying around here, and we're gonna use that to hold this up. We'll tighten that back, we'll tighten that down. And then we'll put the original one back on this guy here, since that one managed to come out without snapping off.